morning from Mobile World Congress Africa here in Kigali. I'm here together with Roman Khalenkov, CEO of PortaOne. Hello, Roman. Nice to meet you.
Thank you. Thank you, Kim.
Roman, the IoT device market is experiencing a rapid growth and value-added services are crucial for differentiation in the market. So what do you think, or from your opinion, how can MVNOs in Africa create IoT solutions or packages to cater to the diverse needs of local communities and industries?
Well, it's not only for MVNOs, it's for MNOs as well. Okay. And I believe that the main issue that every operator is facing is that SIM cards that they provide for connectivity becomes an instant commodity. Imagine if you work with pre-existing IoT companies, well-established IoT companies. For them, you're just a supplier of stupid SIM cards. Mm. Like if somebody comes up with a SIM card which is one rand less expensive per month, they can instantly switch and leave you as their operator and switch to another one. And it becomes a vicious circle. So operators need to come up with something that would retain their customers. Mm. That's
also to create more loyalty.
More loyalty and add more value to what they provide. Yes.
All right. So beyond just providing connectivity, there are other avenues for monetization, obviously. So what strategies might be particularly effective for the MNOs, MNOs in Africa?
Yeah, let's switch from the operator's point of view to the point of view of IoT companies. Mm. Like established IoT companies or IoT startups, how do they work? Like, first of all, they have an idea of how to connect something to the internet in order to manage it. The obvious ideas can be fleet or cargo tracking devices, but IoT goes much beyond that. Imagine flood prevention, like when you trigger an alarm when you see like there is a leakage on a pipe. Or vice versa, like you can control the amount of water that you deliver to water the plants in a garden or in an agriculture sector. You can think of virtual bottles in bars and restaurants. Mm. You can think of connected cows, so to prevent the mortality of cows during the delivery of calves. You can think of fire prevention. You can think of multiple other things, for example, wildlife alerts. Like my company is coming from Canada, and in Vancouver, bears and cougars can be a huge nuisance. And I imagine the same problem can be in Africa as well. So first of all, it's a global problems taken from the local perspectives.
So this IoT itself can actually solve a broad scheme of issues.
Absolutely.
If you do it properly.
Yeah, so you identify the idea. For example, you're an IoT startup. Then you need to figure out what kind of data you need to extract with what sensor. Then there is a huge obstacle, how to transfer that data to a cloud data warehouse, where an IoT platform that people usually develop can manage that data, analyze that, produce reports, and trigger the alerts through the controllers back on the IT devices. So it can be quite complex. And it seems that we have figured out something that can interest both operators and IoT startups.
All right. So coming from a partnership perspective, which always will be a game changer. So which sectors or industries in Africa you think they should focus on? I mean, we discussed just previously that there are many areas where IoT can be helpful, mm-hmm. and can be a proper solution.
I think we can apply the technology to a variety of different IoT applications. Mm-hmm. Pretty much anything what I've mentioned before can be served with our new product. It's called IoT Meal. It's essentially a unified IoT device with multiple sensors, with ability to add more sensors, And what is most importantly, with the ability to transfer the data the sensors collect to the cloud data warehouses, where the IoT companies can actually do their magic and analyze and triggers and so on. So we plan to offer those IoT devices, IoT MIL, to mobile operators, MVNOs, MVNEs, so they can offer those to the end users, to the IoT startups. First of all, it prevents the problem of commoditization of IoT services from the operator's point of view. But most importantly, for IoT startups, it shortens time to market. Usually, like from our experience, what we see is that it takes 10 to 20 months to prototype and to deliver the working IoT solution. We can shorten that period to basically a month, maybe two. So the IoT device is not a prototype, it's a working solution that can work with multiple IoT ideas. The customers can install it right away, not in the lab, but on actual customer premises, and configure the data transfer from the sensors to the data warehouses basically in minutes.
Okay.
So it's already pre-programmed and no other programming is required. All you need is to operate that data with your IoT platform.
That's very interesting. We heard in the conference earlier that so many people are listening on this continent still unconnected, but even there's a usage gap, and especially among a very young group of population. So if we take into account that you bring in a solution for startups where MNOs, MNEs can actually empower startups to quicker develop their solutions, there's also a game changer in terms of IoT, make it affordable for everyone.
Exactly. Affordability is a huge factor here. Well, time equals money.
Yeah.
So if you can shorten the development cycle, if you can shorten the implementation, it would be a huge reinforcement for any IoT startup. So imagine, in terms of money, time is the resources of people, their salaries, that the expectations of the investors and so on. Imagine you can speed it up by 10 times. That opens a wider range of new entrepreneurs and new startups.
I mean, I also see it from a device perspective. You showed me earlier the device and explained me a bit about how future-proven is it from a technology perspective. I'm just imagining the operator offers that actually to startups. That's from my perspective a very interesting point and could be a game changer. Could it, as I said earlier, it could empower them to have quicker future-proven devices at hand to start the development. Because otherwise, especially in this IoT field, when we talk about sensors, etc., and you explained me that you already inbuilt certain sensors into your gateway, so that's a huge step.
Yeah, it's motion sensors, temperature sensors, humidity sensors, and so on. But what is more importantly, any other sensor can be easily connected via Bluetooth, and also it saves the power. IoT MIL comes with a battery which will work for 10 years without recharging.
Right.
Yep, so it's basically a lifetime for a project like that.
Very interesting, thank you. So with the constant evolution of the IoT device market, how can African MNOs, MNOs stay ahead and remain prepared for upcoming innovations?
Well, they should come to PortaOne and talk to us. that would be the first step. And yes, the competition is going to be like really, really strong. And you need to think about the ways how to decommoditize the services you offer. SIM cards is just pure commodity, as we've just discussed.
Yeah.
Try to think of other ways to add value to your customers,
yeah,
to IoT companies, to IoT startups,
yeah,
to anybody who can bring you money.
So would you say that from a revenue stream perspective, on a strategic perspective, IoT still could be the next big thing for an operator?
It is. It is right now, and I believe that we will see it more and more in the future.
All right, interesting. So we just reached almost the end of the second day Mobile World Congress Kigali. So how is it so far for you? Do you see any changes, innovations, movements here in the market? I mean, a lot of the telcos operators are here. Did you have many conversations?
Oh, yes. First of all, there is a big movement in Nigeria right now. So I have seen a lot of Nigerians discussing the new MVNOs. There are like almost 40 new MVNO licenses in Nigeria. They all come to me. I met yesterday, I believe, at least four CEOs of new MVNOs in Nigeria, and they are very excited and anxious again, because they need to focus to find their specific niche.
Yeah.
They need to figure out how to retain their customers in the future, because it's a lot of investment. They don't want to lose it.
Uh-huh. Thank you very much. It was very insightful. Thanks for your time, Roman.
Thank you, Akin.
There was Tech Africa News from Mobile World Congress 2023 here in Kigali. You can find more video interviews, reports, and news on techafricanews.com.